What I want to do though is I want to get a little bit fancier. I want to add those little dots that connect and visually make my eyes flow between the tabs that I've set up. So there's no confusion which phone number goes with which name. And to do that, I want to bring up the dialog box. So when we look at doing this, there is no quick button I can click on to make this magically happen for me. I need to get into the program a little bit further and find the dialog box for setting up my tabs. Tabs are done per paragraph, which helps me know that the dialog box I need is the paragraph dialog box. So when I am in the Home tab and I'm looking at my paragraph group, when you look at the names of the group, if in the lower right-hand corner you see this little curved arrow, it's an indicator that the dialog box is located in there. I'm simply going to click on that little curved arrow. It brings me to the paragraph dialog box, and notice in the lower left-hand corner, I have tabs listed here. And so this is where the dialog box for tabs will be displayed. I'm going to quickly just simply click on that, and it brings up my tab dialog box. Notice that in the upper left-hand corner, I could type in a new tab and add that. And this area right here are the existing tabs, the tabs that I already have set up for what I have selected. Remember that what I have selected is only the paragraph that my cursor was in before I came in here, which was the names and the phone number. So Elvis Presley, Elton John, and their phone numbers, because they are all part of the same paragraph because I did the line breaks to type those in. So I have two tabs set, a 1-inch tab and a 5-inch tab. Notice that it tells me in the alignment area that those are set up for left, or if I click on 1-inch, it tells me it's a left tab and that I have no leader set for that. If I click in the 5-inch tab, it is also a left tab and I have no leader set for that. The question is, which tab do you put the leaders on? Should it be on the 1-inch tab or should it be on the 5-inch tab? To do this, I kind of like to talk to myself about it, and it helps me think about where it should be. Think about the word leader. And specifically, maybe I'll say and ask you, where is the leader of a line? Does the leader of the line come at the beginning of a tab, or would the leader be at the end? Beginning, right? So which tab do I want these dots to lead or be in front of? Remember that my 1-inch tab is the names. Do you want the leader to be in front of this tab? Or in front of the names? No. I want my leader to be in front of my 5-inch tabs or in front of the 5-inch tab. Does that make sense to you? So when I'm choosing, I'm going to choose where I want the tabs, which tab I want the leaders to be in front of. I'm going to click 5 here. Now here's the little dots or dashed or a line that I can put. I'm going to choose the dots and set that, and now when I say okay and go out, I'll see that it places those. What you'll often see people do is try to put period space, and even though sometimes you can get it looking good on your screen, it never looks good when you print it. So when you want this clean, crisp leaders placed in between your tabs, you need to make sure that you ask Word to help you with that. They're lined up and spaced perfectly when you do it that way. Remember, the leader goes in front of the tab that you want to place it, and that is done through the dialog box. I'm going to talk about changing and modifying the tabs that you have set a little bit. Just kind of did it by eyeball where we thought they should go, but you might change your mind. So remember that the tabs that I'm changing now are these tabs where my cursor is active in. It's all one paragraph. So when I change it, it's not going to change anything but these tabs. I actually want to make sure that I change not only these tabs down here, but the name and phone so that they continue to line up together. And they are two separate paragraphs because I have a paragraph mark here and I have one here. So if I want to change both of these paragraphs, I must make sure I select them together. I'm going to do it by going out to the left-hand side in my selection area, pointing at the name line, clicking and dragging through those. I am making sure that I'm not going above that or below that if I had blank lines, because it will show me just the tabs that I want to be modifying. So now that I have those selected, I'm going to go up to the ruler where I have my tab mark, and I'm going to take that tab and drag it along the ruler. Notice as you drag it along the ruler, you can simply keep it in there and change the position of that. They are all changing together because I have both paragraphs selected. If I only had one, I would only be changing one. I have decided to change the type of tab I have in here from a left tab to a right tab. So to change it or to remove a tab, I may simply click on that tab, and this time I'm going to drag it down into the paper. When I let go, oh, my tabs are all messed up. I'm not going to worry about that. That's because I no longer have a tab that pushes it over to the right-hand side. I'm going to go to my tab marker here, click until I see a right tab. That's what a right tab looks like. I don't drag it out to the ruler. Now I simply verify the marker has the right kind of tab, move out to the ruler. This time I'm going to place it close to the edge of my paper, and I'm going to click inside the ruler. Bam! I have a right tab, and notice that the tabs line up on the right-hand side instead of the left-hand side. And that's the difference between a right and a left-hand tab. Now, because I removed my right tab from the, or my left tab from the ruler, it also moved the dot leaders because those belonged with that left tab. So I've lost my dot leaders. Do you remember how to put them back in? If I do it now, I will have it on all three of my tabs. I've decided that's okay. I want to do that. Take a second and think, where did we go to find the tab dialog box? Remember, tabs are set up per paragraph. Oh, so I'm going to go to the paragraph group and I need to do the paragraph dialog launcher, which is this curved arrow. Here I am in the paragraph dialog box in the lower left-hand corner. I'll click to open up the tab dialog box. Which tab should I set that dot leader on? Tab at the 1-inch mark or the tab at the 6.25-inch mark? Remember, I want the leader to be in front of the tab, so I want it in front of my second tab. I'm going to choose 6.25, choose the type I want, set it, OK. And now, because I had all three selected, I have the dot leader in front of all three of those tabs. And that's just a simple introduction to tabs. Remember that you can set tabs using the dialog box or the ruler. I think it's easiest to do it in the ruler. It's also easy to modify. You just have to keep in mind, select the things that you want to change if you have multiple paragraphs selected, and then they'll all change and move together. Good luck!